It's one small step for man, one giant leap for mankind.
Hey there, Eagles, and welcome to school for the week of March 9th. It's the happiest week of the year.
Let's turn to Miss Rogers' class for the Pledge of Allegiance.
Please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance. Ready? Begin. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thanks, Ms. Rogers class. Job well done.
Let's see what's happening at Armstrong this week. How exciting. Today is the day. The clash of classes will begin today.
Let's check into our weather porch to see what we can expect this week.
So this is how it looked like at the end of last week. So it was kind of cloudy. Here's this week's forecast, and it's gonna be kind of hot, around the 60s. But on Thursday and Friday, there's a chance of rain, but on Monday, it's gonna be 56 degrees.
Thanks for the update. It looks like last week's snow has been replaced by warmer temperatures. In many ways, it looks like the happiest week of the year.
We've got a few terrific Armstrong Eagles who represent Armstrong in the regional science fair. Let's turn to them to learn more about their accomplishments.
So we all made it on to the next level of the science fair, which is region, and it's where we get to go up to the U of U for a whole day and get judged by a bunch of different real scientists. And so my project, I tested lead in the soil near the Bingham Canyon Mine in areas where children often are, and I found out there was some lead in the soil, but not enough to be harmful to children.
So me and Jenna, we did a science project, and our question was, which disinfectant cleans hands the best?
What we did is we went to a laboratory, Nelson Labs, and we tested the germs on our hands, and we saw which disinfectant cleaned hands the best.
My project was on which water solution will hatch brine shrimp the fastest. The results were the salt solution hatched them the fastest.
Awesome work, Eagles. Thanks for representing Armstrong so well.
It's time once again for another weekly whip around. Pretty cool stuff, Armstrong. Thanks for sharing.
We've got a few more readers to highlight in the Armstrong Reading Blast-Off. Take a look.
Butterfly in the sky, I can go twice as high. Take a look, it's in a book, a reading rainbow. And ways to grow, a reading rainbow. I can be anything. Take a look, it's in a book, a reading rainbow.
A reading rainbow, a reading rainbow, a reading rainbow.
Fabulous job, readers.
A couple weeks ago, we saw the Astonishing Attendance Award handed out. What about the Greatest Grade Award? Well, take a look.
Second grade, you won Greatest Grade for November and December. That is so awesome. Here you go.
Greatest grade.
Good job.
I'm here to tell you that the third grade in January won the Greatest Grade Award. Film man. All right. Okay, I want to remind you of something. Fourth grade won it in September and October, and second grade won it in November and December. Okay, so this, everyone else has beat you. You've only won it once. So if you want to win it twice like the rest of them, here's what you've got to do. We give you points for doing three things, and the grade with the most points wins. You can earn points for getting a gratitude gram. You can earn points for finishing a book series, and you can earn points for, what's the last one? Earning medals on IXL. Okay? So keep up those three things, and the grade with the most points on all three of those things will win the greatest grade for February, and then we got March coming up too.
Nice work. Congratulations on being the greatest grade.
Well, that's it for us. Thanks for watching.
This is ABC News.